We got bluebird skies, zero wind. It's 9 a.m. I'm gonna start with a drop shot out here after we pinpoint some fish as we're coming up on the structure here. We're about 60 feet away from it. I put my Mega Live on the same side as my steering knob. It lets me use this freehand right here to do either the steering or scan quick for the Mega Live. Mega 360 over here just stays in place. It's always giving me a picture around the entire boat. Okay, there's some fish out on top of that little high spot. Okay, I landed at 40 feet. There's fish on it, right there. It was that easy. That's too easy. It's a fun too easy, but it's too easy. Trust your electronics. Why go cast blind the entire day just to make yourself feel like you did something? I just got out here in the second cast. Stuck a fish. Big largemouth. It might be a fun day. This Megabass Hazedong shad should get absolutely destroyed today. Lucky I have about 6 packs with. Just nose hooking that little minnow. Feet, 9:30. You can see I'm fighting that fish on the drop shot. It's trying to stay down the weeds. Oh, there it came up there. It's going back down to the weeds. You can see it perfect on the live. It's a big fish. It's a big bass, man. Oh. Mega Live, Mega 360. Megabass Hazedong shad. Look at that. Got the Arsenal drop shot weight on there. Oh, what do we got there? Hazedong shad. Let's get a weight on this fish quick. Gotta be at least 4.25, 4.5, I would think. At least. 454. Okay, we're coming up on the high spot here. It's 7.5 feet. drops into that 12 to 15. There's another fish. Back-to-back cast. I turned around, and a school of bass came right back towards me underneath the kayak. It's as simple as just dropping it down there. I could see right when it swam up to that drop shot. He's in tow mode. There you saw him, 954. He wants over the bottom and came shooting back up. Pretty nice fish for catching underneath the kayak. You can love electronics or you can hate them. But you know what? If you love them, it doesn't matter what the next guy thinks. You can have fun smashing fish and enjoying every single one of them. So I'm tying a new leader on. And I'm going from 10 pound braid, high vis so I can see bites, to an 8 pound fluorocarbon, and it's that modified Alberto. A lot of guys are starting to tie the FG knot or have been using that. I just have never ever had an issue with this. It casts good for me. I don't break it. I got fish from underneath the kayak. I'm patiently trying to tie. I knocked my scissors over, so I'm going to have to order a new one. Got my old one with. Not the best. Still have a fish on below me. I'm going to mix it up a little bit here. And put a little mini tube on. A little 2.5 incher. Thank you. side of this point, there's a bunch of fish there. 10:56 a.m. They weren't up on top, they were on the sloping side. It's a largemouth. There's a bunch more with it up there, so we'll back off of there a little bit. Hazedong right down where it needs to be. Big rock. 11:44 on the clock. We got three or four big rocks out here, 12 and a half to 14 feet. I just missed a couple bites on there. Got my Hazedong shad. Oh, it's a big bass. There's no doubt it's the biggest fish I've caught in a stretch here. Holy smokes, that's a solid tank. Look at this. That is a specimen right there. The old drop shot. Hazedong shad. My Megabass stuff just keeps putting big fish in the boat.